जीवन खेले फरायन मन सा चंद्र चखोरा नमशुदरास को कृष्ण यास रखो वचन मन मोहरा जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जान बल्लभ गिरिवरधारी गोपी जान बल्लभ गिरिवरधारी यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरावन चाहरी यमुना तीरावन चाहरी नित्य गौर हरिबो 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 नित्य गौर हरिबो गौर प्रेमानंदे ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
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 ओम नमो भगवते
नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् नस्तप्रयेषु वभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवति उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्टिकी कृष्णे स्वधामो भगते धर्मज्ञानदिभिः कलो निष्ठादृशमे च पूरणार्थो जनो जितः. We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter Number 13, Dhritarashtra Quits Home. Text number 59.
तो हम लोग श्रीमद् भागवतम पढ़ने जा रहे हैं. श्रीमद् भागवतम एक स्कंद अध्याय 13 श्लोक संख्या 59 ही धृतराष्ट्र द्वारा शरीर छोड़ना या घर राज्य छोड़ जाना.
विदुरस्तु तदाश्चर्यम् निशम्या कुरुनंदना हर्षशोकयुतस्तस्मात् गन्तातीर्थनिषेवका विदुरस्तु तदाश्चर्यम् निशम्यं कुरुनंदना हर्षशोकयुतस्तस्मात् गन्ततीर्थनिषेवका विदुरस्तु तदाश्चर्यम् निशम्या कुरुनंदना हर्षशोकयुतस्तस्मात् गन्ततीर्थनिषेवका
विदुरस्तु तदाश्चर्यम्
विदुरस्तु तदाश्चर्यम्
निशम्य
कुरुनंदना
हर्षशोकयुतस्तस्मात्
हर्षशोकयुतस्तस्मात्
दन्तातीर्थनिषेवका
दन्तातीर्थनिषेवका
विदुरस्तु तदाश्चर्यम्
विदुरस्तु तदाश्चर्यम् गुरुनंदना
Okay. Viduras.
Vidura
also.
Vidura also.
Tu.
Tu.
But.
But.
Tat.
Tat.
That incident.
That incident.
Ascharyam.
Ascharyam.
Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Nishamya,
Nishamya,
seeing,
seeing.
Kurunandana,
Kurunandana,
O son of the Kuru dynasty,
O son of the Kuru dynasty.
Harsha,
Harsha,
delight,
delight.
Shoka,
Shoka,
grief,
grief.
Yuta,
Yuta,
affected by,
affected by.
Tasmat,
Tasmat,
from that place,
from that place.
Ganta,
Ganta
will go away.
Will go away.
Tirtha,
Tirtha,
place of pilgrimage.
Place of pilgrimage.
Nishevaka,
Nishevaka,
for being enlivened.
For being enlivened.
Translation: Vidura, being affected with delight and grief, will then leave that place of sacred pilgrimage.
तब हर्ष तथा शोक से विभूत होकर महात्मा विदुर उस पवित्र तीर्थ स्थान से चले जाएंगे.
Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Vidura was astonished to see the marvelous departure of his brother Dhritarashtra as a liberated yogi. For in his past life, he was much attached to materialism. Of course, it was only due to Vidura that his brother attained the desirable goal of life. Vidura was therefore glad to learn about it, but he was sorry that he could not make his brother into a pure devotee. This was not this was not done by Vidura because of Dhritarashtra's being inimical to the Pandavas, who were all devotees of the Lord. An offense at the feet of a Vaishnava is more dangerous than an offense at the lotus feet of the Lord. Vidura was certainly very liberal to bestow mercy upon his brother Dhritarashtra, whose past life was very materialistic. But ultimately, the result of such mercy certainly depended on the will of the Supreme Lord in the present life. Therefore, Dhritarashtra attained liberation only, and after many such liberated states of life, one can attain to the stage of devotional service. Vidura was certainly very mortified by the death of his brother and sister-in-law, and the only remedy to mitigate such lamentation was to go out to pilgrimage. Thus, Maharaj Yudhisthira had no chance to call back Vidura, his surviving uncle.
तात्पर्य महात्मा विदुर मुक्त योगी के रूप में अपने भ्राता धृतराष्ट्र के आश्चर्य में प्रियान को देखकर चकित थे, क्योंकि वे अपने विगत जीवन में भौतिकवाद में अत्यधिक लिप्त थे। निसंदेह महात्मा विदुर के ही कारण उनके भाई को जीवन की वांछित गति प्राप्त हुई। अतः यह जानकर महात्मा विदुर परम प्रसन्न थे, लेकिन उन्हें दुख था कि वे अपने भाई को शुद्ध भक्त न बना पाए। महात्मा विदुर ऐसा ना कर पाए क्योंकि महाराज धृतराष्ट्र उन पांडवों से शत्रु भाव रखते थे जो सभी श्री भगवान के भक्त थे। वैष्णव के चरण कमलों पर किया गया अपराध श्री भगवान के चरण कमलों पर किए गए अपराध से अधिक घातक होता है। निश्चय ही महात्मा विदुर अपने भाई महाराज धृतराष्ट्र पर अत्यंत कृपालु थे, जिनका पिछला जीवन अत्यंत भौतिकवादी था, किंतु ऐसी कृपा का वर्तमान जीवन में फल अतः परमेश्वर की इच्छा पर निर्भर होता है। अतः महाराज धृतराष्ट्र को केवल मुक्ति लाभ हुआ। ऐसे अनेक मुक्त जीवनों के पश्चात ही भक्ति की अवस्था प्राप्त होती है। महात्मा विदुर अपने भाई तथा भाभी के देहांत से अत्यंत शोकातुर थे, पर ऐसे शोक को दूर करने का एकमात्र उपाय था कि वे तीर्थ यात्रा के लिए निकल पड़े। अतः महाराज युधिष्ठिर के पास अपने जीवित चाचा महाराज महात्मा विदुर को वापस बुलाने का अवसर न था।
ओम ज्ञान तमरंदस्य चक्षुरुन्मीलितं तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन बुद्धिः स्वयं रूपकदामयं ददाति स्वापदन्तिकं देहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयतापरकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवंश्च श्रीरूपं सकृजातं सहगना रघुनतन्वितं तं सजीवं सद्वैतं सर्वदूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपदं सहगना ललिता श्रीविशाखानितंश्च हे कृष्णकरणसिन्धु दीनबन्धु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकन्त राधाकन्त नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगे राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी नमामि हरिप्रिये। पञ्चकौपतृभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिनः। नमस्ते सरस्वती भवानी प्रचारिणे भास्कर चंदे सतारिणे। Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasade Gaur Bhaktam Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. So Narada Muni is telling to Maharaj Yudhisthira about the future of Dhritarashtra and Gandhari and Vidura. Dhritarashtra and Gandhari had got out of the house under the instructions of Vidura and gone into the forest. Dhritarashtra had received the instruction from Vidura. Gandhari simply followed her husband. So Vidura was very kind that he came home to instruct Dhritarashtra before he left the body. And Vidura was able to preach very powerfully and very convincingly. Dhritarashtra was very attached materially. He was very comfortable staying in the home of his enemies. He was eating the food, the remnants of Bhima, who had killed all of his sons. Vidura was astonished to see how degraded his brother Dhritarashtra was. But still Vidura wanted to save him, because Vidura is Yamaraj, and Yamaraj is one of the Mahajans. So he was kind to Dhritarashtra by giving him very painful instructions. The business of the sadhu is not to flatter people. Sometimes sadhus, some people will come and they will talk and they will simply entertain and speak nice, and they will never speak the real truth. They will never reveal to people what is the real purpose of life and what is the real standards of civilized life. Just like there's one temple, there's a Hindu temple in Hong Kong, and they will tell you, you can come and give class, but don't tell people not to eat meat. Don't criticize the people. So what's the point? There's no purpose to go to try to educate people. If the people are all sinful and degraded, and you simply go and flatter them and make them laugh, that is not the real purpose of spiritual knowledge. Business of the sadhu is to speak the truth, whether people like it or not. Just like doctor, sometimes they have to cut. Right, sometimes I was in India one time, I was in Hyderabad, and I got this infection on my arm, and you know, it got very swollen, and it was poison, and there was a line going up my arm. And when the doctor saw it, he said, "Oh, you have to get surgery immediately." So of course you may say, "No, no, no, please, I don't want surgery. Don't cut me." Doctor said, "No, if I don't cut you, the poison's going to go to your heart. You'll die." So you may say, "Oh, no, no, please don't cut. Just give me some medicine." Doctors say, "No, there's no medicine. The only cure is to cut." So same way, sadhu sometimes come, they have to speak. Sometimes they have to speak the truth. They have to, and it's painful sometimes for people. The sadhu comes and said, "You're in Maya. You're doing your own nonsense. You eat garbage food. You engage in sinful activities. You're going to hell." People will say, "Oh, I don't like that sadhu." The sadhu is giving the real mercy. He's trying to open the eyes, but the people don't want to see. Just like there's a bird, the owl. The owl only opens his eyes in the night. And so in the night, the other animals may come, they say to the owl, "Whoa, the sun was so hot today." The owl will say, "I never saw any sun." No, owl did not see the sun because the eyes were closed all day. You want to see the sun, you have to open your eyes. But people, you get people like the owl, they will not open their eyes. They don't want to see. And so sadhus like Vidura, they're very expert to force the people to see the truth.
Jaise sadhu,
So Vidura was so kind to Dhritarashtra. He came there and he got him out of the house. We may say, oh, that's cruel. They should have let him stay in the house. He's an old man. But the Vedic culture is that you're supposed to get out from the house. And when you go out from the house, people will say, where did he go? Just like Maharaj Yudhisthira came. He said, where are my uncles? Where's my aunt? Where have they gone? And then Maharaj Yudhisthira understood they had left the home. And he said, I have been cheated by these great souls. So by the grace of Vidura, even Dhritarashtra could become a great soul. He got out of the house, he got out of that well of family life. Right, for materialistic people, just like Prahlad Maharaj was telling his father that, my dear father, king of the demons, that you're in the well, you should go to the forest. When people are attached to materialistic life, the only hope is to go come away from everything and go to the forest. So Srila Prabhupada explains, Vidura could not make Dhritarashtra into a pure devotee. But he was able to get him to the platform of liberation. Liberation is not pure devotion. But it's better than being a karmi. Now we see Ajamila. Ajamila was also, he was a sinful person, but he was able to become a pure devotee. Ajamila was not an offender of devotees. But he was sinful. You know, he left his wife and he went off with another woman. And he was drinking and gambling and stealing. But somehow he had called the name, he's given his son the name Narayan. And this brought the Vishnu Duts, protected him from the Yamaduts. And then Ajamila could go home, leave the home, and go to stay at a Vishnu temple and become a good devotee.
So,
So Achamila was sinful, but he was not an aparadi.
Ajamil thoda paapi tha, par wo aparadi nahi tha. Matlab paap nahi karta tha Vaishnav ke
upar. Now Daksha, he was a very learned person. He was a prajapati.
Daksha was the prajapati.
And Daksha, he was an offender.
Wo aparadhi tha, Daksh prajapati. Padha likha gyani tha, fir bhi wo aparadhi tha, matlab
Vaishnav. Right, he committed offenses against Lord Shiva. So Daksha, he got his head cut off and got it replaced with the head of a goat. So Daksha, he couldn't become a pure devotee, although he had association with great devotees. And although he was Prajapati, and he was in charge of all the yajna in the heavenly planets. All the devas were all respecting him. And he had such even one of his daughters was Sati, who became the wife of Lord Shiva. And he had many sons, and Narada Muni made all of his sons into great devotees. But Daksha himself was an offender of devotees. So similarly here, Dhritarashtra cannot take up bhakti yet, but he can get liberation by the mercy of Vidura.
So, aise hi Maharaja Dhritarashtra, Vidur ki kripa se hi mukti ke raah pe chal paaye, par shuddh bhakti nahi banta.
Yeah, if you do service for the devotees. It said, Mahatsevam Dwara Mahor Vimuktis. By serving the devotees, opens the doors to liberation. But to become the devotee, to take up devotional service, you have to get free of sinful reactions and you have to not offend the devotees. Now Dhritarashtra, he had offended the Pandavas. He'd been very offensive. He'd been hoping his sons would kill the Pandavas. He was supposed to be the guardian and the caretaker of the Pandavas. After Pandu died, Dhritarashtra was supposed to take care of the Pandavas. But instead of taking care of them, he was always bitter. And he always wanted his sons to be over, to be in a superior position to the Pandavas. Even Vidura had tried to give instruction to Dhritarashtra when before the battle of Kurukshetra. Vidura had tried to instruct Dhritarashtra, don't listen to your son Duryodhan. But Dhritarashtra was so attached to his own children, he could not see the truth.
But Dhritarashtra was so attached to his own children, he could not see the truth. और इसलिए वो अपने दिल की बात नहीं आत्मा की बात सुन रहे।
But after they've all been killed, after the battle of Kurukshetra is over, and Dhritarashtra is near to death, Vidura is so kind and merciful that he came back and preached to Dhritarashtra.
युद्ध के पश्चात, कुरुक्षेत्र के युद्ध के पश्चात, जब सारे उनके बेटे मर गए, तो कितने राजा विदुर कितने दयालु कृपालु थे जो उन्होंने समझा रहे हैं और उनको बोल रहे कि बंदी बचो।
So Vidura was very happy to see Dhritarashtra go to the forest, Gandhari go there also, and Dhritarashtra went, sat in meditation, and he was able to give up his material body and get liberation.
Abhi Maharaja Vidura bahut khush the ki wo ja rahe hai, van mein ja rahe hai, aur wo wahan par baith kar dhyan karenge aur fir apni sharir ka tyag kar denge wahan par aur bhagwan mukti pa lenge.
So the liberation he got, that is Sayujya Mukti, that is not what a devotee wants. But still it's a good destination for someone like Dhritarashtra to achieve. So Vidura was happy to see his brother liberated. But he was sorry that he could not give him pure devotional service. And so, mixed feelings when he saw his brother depart from the world. He had mixed feelings. He was happy in one way, but he was sad in another.
So, Maharaja Vidura ko dono hi bhavna thi. Ek to sukh the ki kam se kam to mukti mili, aur ek to dukhit bhi the ki unko shuddh darshan nahi mil
paya. So, when we have this kind of situation, when we see our family members depart from the world, our relatives, we feel pained in the heart, and the best remedy is to go a pilgrimage, to go to holy place.
So, जैसे हमें भी अपने घर पे या रिश्तेदार घर वाले ऐसे होते हैं जो जाते हैं, ऐसे तो हमें भी कई बार ऐसे ही फीलिंग होती
है. Somebody dies. It's an opportunity for us to go to the holy place. Maybe can take the ashes of the departed soul and bring them to the holy river, put them in the holy river. Or you can simply go yourself to the holy place and take shelter of the holy people who live there and hear from them transcendental knowledge. By hearing transcendental knowledge, then we can pacify our disturbed mind at the loss of our dear relatives.
तो हम ऐसे तीर्थस्थानों पर जाएंगे और हम शुद्ध ज्ञान को प्राप्त करेंगे, तो फिर अगर कोई मर भी जाता है तो हम उसके उस दुख से हम निकल सकते हैं।
Yeah, we can think that they have gone from the world. In the future, it will be my turn. I'm next to go.
वो चले गए हैं, पर हमें महसूस होता है कि आगे भविष्य में हम भी जाएंगे।
I have to prepare for leaving this world.
तो मुझे भी तैयारी करनी है यहाँ से निकलने के बाद जाने की।
I have to become more serious in my practice of spiritual life.
तो मुझे भी बहुत ज़्यादा गंभीर होना है, जो मैं कृष्णा, जो कृष्ण भावना में हूँ, तो मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा और सीरियस होना है।
I have to give up all my sinful activities.
सब कुछ मुझे यहाँ छोड़ के जाना है, सारे कर्म और सारे पाप।
I have to stop wasting time nonsense talking and watching so many mundane movies. I have to fix my mind on the lotus feet of Lord Krishna and become ready to go out from this world.
So मेरा मन और चित्त भगवान श्री कृष्ण के चरण अक्षर कदमों में लगना चाहिए ताकि मैं जहाँ जाना है उसकी तैयारी कर सकूँ।
So Prabhupada explains in the purport for Dhritarashtra, he got liberation, but you have to take many births before he ever becomes a devotee.
So, यहाँ प्रभुपाद बता रहे हैं कि इसको उनको मुक्ति तो मिली, पर ये मुक्ति मिलने के बाद कई जन्मों के बाद ही शुद्ध भक्त बन सकते
Bahunam Janmanamanti Gyanavam Amprapajanti. After many births and deaths, then one who is actually in knowledge, then he surrenders to Vasudev Krishna. Liberation, the platform of liberation means no material suffering.
जो मुक्ति का जो बताया मुक्ति के बारे में वहाँ पर कोई भी भौतिक बात से लेकर जैसे कोई भी दुख और सुख नहीं
No material suffering, but no spiritual happiness.
जो कोई भी जैसे कि वहाँ दुख नहीं है संसारिक दुख नहीं है पर वहाँ कोई भी भगवान जैसे भगवान के प्रति जो हमारी श्रद्धा है या भगवान के प्रति जो सुख है वो नहीं मिलेगा
The bliss of spiritual life is denied to the impersonalists. Only the devotees can relish the pleasure of service to Krishna. Impersonalists, their philosophy is more dry. There's no rasa, there's no taste.
मायावादी का जो भी होता है उनका बहुत सूखा सूखा होता है वो मतलब प्रेम रंग में नहीं रंग पाते।
There's no suffering, but there's no spiritual bliss.
तो वहाँ पर कोई दुख नहीं है, पर वहाँ पर जो प्रेम भी नहीं है।
But the devotees can taste that bliss by their service to Krishna.
बट शुद्ध भक्त है वो भगवान का प्रेम, भगवान की कृपा को साक्षात महसूस करते हैं और करते रहेंगे।
We want to get that higher taste. Not just the pleasure of the senses, the happiness of eating and sleeping. We want to get spiritual bliss.
हम यहाँ पर जब भी भक्ति करते हैं तो हम केवल अपने इंद्रियों तृप्ति के लिए खाना पीने के लिए नहीं हम एक्चुअली जो हमें भगवान की कृपा का और भगवान के प्रेम का जो लेना होता है वो हमारे इंद्रियों से हमारे मन से बाहर होता है
So spiritual bliss is given to those who engage in devotional service, who have that devotional attitude.
So भगवान की कृपा और भगवान का प्रेम, भगवान के चरण कमलों में उनकी सेवा करने में और वैष्णवों की सेवा करने में ही
But Dhritarashtra's business has been to offend the devotees.
But जो धृतराष्ट्र का जो उन्होंने कर्म किए
So he will never get the bliss of spiritual pleasure. Until he overcomes that tendency to attack and to criticize devotee.
So इससे उनकी भावना मतलब जो भक्त के प्रति जो भी उनको गलत बोलना या उनकी निंदा करना वो करते हैं
So the first offense in chanting the holy name is a mad elephant offense to blaspheme the devotees who have dedicated their life propagating the holy name.
So पहला अपराध जो बताया गया है कि हमें किसी भी वैष्णव के ऊपर आलोचना नहीं करनी चाहिए.
Vidura had been trying to tell he'd been trying to tell Dhritarashtra and trying to warned Dhritarashtra about his son Duryodhana, but Dhritarashtra would not hear.
बहुत महाराजा विदुर ने बहुत प्रयास किया कि धृतराष्ट्र को बताए उनके पुत्रों के बारे में कैसे पर धृतराष्ट्र सुनने को तैयार नहीं
However, after Kurukshetra war and Dhritarashtra's sons are all dead and Duryodhana's also dead, then Dhritarashtra is more ready to hear.
तो जैसे जब कुरुक्षेत्र का युद्ध हो गया दुर्योधन भी मर गया सभी पुत्र मर गए उसके
उसके बाद व्यास सुनने को थोड़ा तैयार हुआ.
So Vidura came to give him, to open his eyes, to help him to understand what he had to do.
So ab Vidura aaye, uske baad Vidura ne samjhaya, fir unki aankhein khuli aur fir wo maanne ko swikar karne ko taiyar ho gaye.
Of course, what he really wanted was to make him a pure devotee, but wasn't ready for that yet.
वो स्वभावतः विदुर ने पूरी कोशिश की, अपना पूरा प्रयास किया कि भाई मेरा भाई प्योर डिवोटी बन जाए, मतलब शुद्ध भक्त बन जाए, पर नहीं, वो सुनने को तैयार नहीं.
But at least he could get him to become a liberated soul, to get out of birth and death.
लेकिन फिर भी उसने प्रयास किया कि इसको उनको मुक्ति मिले, कम से कम इस मायावादी दुख में फंसे हुए से निकल जाए.
Of course, that destination, that is also given to the people who are killed by Krishna. The different demons who came attacking Krishna, like the wrestlers in Mathura, Chanura, Mustika, they got impersonal liberation.
जैसे बहुत से असुर ने उनको मारने की कोशिश की भगवान कृष्ण को, तो उनको भी मुक्ति मिल गई.
They enter into the world of liberation.
वे भी मुक्ति के जो द्वार में पहुंच गए.
But there's no active service there.
पर वहां कोई भी सेवा नहीं है भगवान के प्रति.
There's only the feeling of oneness. So for a devotee, that is not desirable. A devotee wants opportunity to do service for Krishna. So who can become a devotee? Of course, you need the mercy of a devotee. Well, the mercy of Vidura was there. But one who is the offender to pure devotees, they cannot take advantage of the mercy of a devotee. We give the example about Daksha. So here also,
Dhritarashtra.
He's not going to get the highest, the real mercy of a devotee. But he got benefit. Okay, any question?
So, Maharaj, we do many devotion activity. We are happy in devotion, but we still suffer in, misery in this world. Can you advise about this?
माता जी का प्रश्न है कि हम सेवा भी करते हैं और भक्तों की सेवा करते हैं, फिर भी इस संसार में बहुत दुख प्राप्त होता है.
Yes, you have to understand that even for the Pandavas there was a lot of difficulties, there were a lot of troubles. Mother Kunti also had many calamities in her life.
महाराज बता रहे, जैसे अभी देखो पांडवों का उदाहरण दिया और महारानी कुंती ने कितने दुख सहे अपने जीवन में.
So we should not think that because I'm a devotee, because I'm doing devotional service, I won't have any troubles.
तो हमें ऐसे नहीं सोचना चाहिए कि मैं एक शुद्ध भक्त हूँ या भक्त हूँ तो मेरे जीवन में दुख नहीं आएंगे.
No. Troubles will be there. You have a material body, you're going to get disease, you're going to get old age, One day you have to die.
हमारी जैसे ये काया है, हमारा शरीर है, तो इसमें बीमारी भी आएगी, बुढ़ापा भी आएगा, पर अंतिम में हमें जाना ही होगा.
You cannot think, I'm a devotee. Why I should get disease? Why I should get old?
तुम्हें हम devotee तो हमें ऐसे नहीं सोचना चाहिए कि भाई मुझे क्यों दुख हो रहा है, मुझे क्यों बीमार हो रहा है, मैं क्यों बूढ़ी हो रही
हूँ. No. We have to understand we have taken the material body and the material world. So we have to finish the karma.
हमें सोचना चाहिए कि हमें यहाँ पर भौतिक वाद में आए, मतलब मृत्यु लोक में आए हुए हैं, तो हमें तो यहाँ पर ये सब करना ही होगा.
So the devotee, the sign of a devotee is that they will tolerate all the difficulties and go on serving Krishna.
So, एक भक्त को ये सोचना चाहिए कि सहनशील बनना चाहिए और भगवान की सेवा में और भक्तों की सेवा में लगे रहना चाहिए.
तथे न कंपाम सुसमिक्षमाना
तथे न कंपाम सुसमिक्षमाना.
Do you know the rest of the verse? Vatma kritam vipaka rig vagva puvir vidadan namaste jiveta yo mukti pade sadhaya bak. So Krishna is ajita, but he becomes conquered by the pure love of his devotee.
भगवान श्री कृष्ण अजीत हैं, जिसको जीता नहीं जा सकता, पर भगवान की भक्ति से और भगवान के प्रेम से उनको जीता जा सकता
है. A devotee will tolerate all the difficulties, but go on with his service to Krishna.
भगवान के भक्त को बहुत पीड़ा, बहुत संकट आ सकता है, पर फिर भी वो भगवान की सेवा में निरंतर लगा रहता है.
So you could say the difficulties which you are getting in the life, they're like a test. How serious are you to be a devotee?
कोई भी परेशानी आती है किसी भक्त में, तो आपका वो परीक्षा है कि आप कितने गंभीर हो भगवान के राम में.
Oh, if I get sick, I don't. Krishna's not protecting me.
अगर आप बीमार हो तो आपको लगता है कि मुझे कि भगवान कृष्ण मुझे नहीं बचा रहे हैं.
No, Krishna's testing you. He wants to see how serious are you to be a devotee.
Bhagwan Shri Krishna aapki pariksha le rahe hai ki aap kitne gambhir ho.
Are you going to tolerate all the difficulties and keep serving Krishna?
Aap kitne sahanshil ho us pariksha ko paar karne ke liye aur kitne aap bhagwan ke prati nirantar bhakti mein aur prem mein lage ho.
Are you going to give up? Oh, I'm not going to be a devotee. I still get sick. Oh, I still get troubles. Why I should be a devotee? I'm not getting protected. Krishna's not protecting me.
और आपके दूसरा ऑप्शन ये भी आप कई भक्त ऐसे सोचते हैं कि मैं सब कुछ छोड़ दूँ अब तक कुछ भगवान कृष्ण मुझे बचा नहीं रहे मैं बीमार हूँ मैं बूढ़ा हो गया हूँ बूढ़ी हूँ.
The devotee will think that I'm meant to suffer more, but Krishna's only giving me a little suffering.
तो एक भक्त को सोचना चाहिए कि भगवान मेरी परीक्षा ले रहे हैं, भगवान मुझे दे रहे हैं कष्ट, पर भगवान को और भी देना था पर मुझे कष्ट कम करके दे रहे हैं.
And when you're happy, you should think, I don't deserve all this. Krishna is just encouraging me.
जब हम खुश होते हैं तो हमें सोचना चाहिए कि हमें ये सब खुशी भगवान कृष्ण से मिली है और हमें बहुत ज़्यादा मोटिवेट कर रहे हैं, हमें प्रेरित कर रहे हैं और खुशी प्राप्त.
So in every situation, a devotee thanks Krishna. He sees the mercy of Krishna.
So, एक भक्त को हर परिस्थिति में भगवान का धन्यवाद करना चाहिए, चाहे सुख हो या दुख.
Okay.
धन्यवाद गुरु महाराज.
Hare Krishna Maharaj, thank you very much for wonderful class with example and analysis. My question is that. How we can see the practically in this age of Kali, that this topic was in age of Dwapar Yuga, the Dhritarashtra offended towards the Pandavas, who was a devotee, and he didn't get the pure devotion, and although Vidur was he was qualified to take up Dhritarashtra in pure stage, because he knew that Dhritarashtra was offended, that's why he didn't do that. And also we can see the age of Kali, the Chappal Gopal, he was offender of Srivas Acharya, but he got that love of God. So how we can understand, please enlighten.
हरे कृष्णा। तो
हम देख सकते हैं कि ये द्वापर युग की बात है कि कैसे धृतराष्ट्र ने पांडवों के प्रति अपराध किए थे, वो तो द्वापर युग था, लेकिन हम लोग कली युग के हैं, तो हम इस चीज़ों को कैसे प्रैक्टिकल में करेंगे। और दूसरी बात यह है कि विदुर इतना शुद्ध भक्त थे, वो कर सकते थे, लेकिन वो ये जानते थे कि धृतराष्ट्र ने पांडवों के प्रति अपराध किए थे, इसलिए उन्होंने ऊपर नहीं उठाए वहाँ तक प्योर डिवोशन तक। और दूसरी बात यह है कि हम कली युग में देखते हैं कि चापल गोपाल जो एक काली के भक्त था, लेकिन उन्होंने श्रीवास आचार्य जो भगवान के पार्षद है उनके ऊपर अपराध किए थे, तो फिर भी उनको भगवान का प्रेम प्राप्त हुआ अल्टीमेटली।
सो गोपाल चापला, he got the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, and in the Kali Yuga people can get the mercy, they can be delivered. Even sinful people.
तो बिना तो हम देख सकते हैं क्योंकि कली युग में चापल गोपाल तो कली युग के थे, इसलिए उन्होंने भक्तों का अपराध तो किया है, फिर भी चैतन्य महाप्रभु की कृपा प्राप्त किए हैं।
But Dhritarashtra, this is from the previous yuga.
तो ये धृतराष्ट्र का जो था वो पहले के युग था, मतलब द्वापर युग।
And because the Pandavas were such great devotees, so his offense
जो पांडव थे वो बहुत ही अच्छे भक्त थे, भगवान के उच्च स्तर के भक्त।
So his offense was very great.
तो इसलिए धृतराष्ट्र का जो अपराध था वो विशेष अपराध था, ज्यादा
ही। To be delivered, Vidura gave him he gave him instruction, and then he let him go into the forest.
तो विदुर ने धृतराष्ट्र को उपदेश दिए थे कि चलिए हम जंगल में जाते हैं।
You know, like Ajamila, we said Ajamila, what did he do after he heard the conversation between the Vishnu Dutas and the Yamaduras? Ajamila went to a Vishnu temple and took shelter there and did service in the temple.
इस संदर्भ में हम देख सकते हैं कि जिस प्रकार अजामिल जब विष्णु दूत और यमदूत की चर्चा हो रहा था तो उसमें अजामिल ने सब कुछ सुना था, सुनने के बाद वो तुरंत चला गया हरिद्वार के साइड में और मंदिर में, विष्णु मंदिर में जाकर उन्होंने शरण ली।
And then he gave up his body in the Ganga.
और उन्होंने क्या किया, बाद में अपने शरीर को गंगा में शरीर किया।
Ajamil had gone to Haridwar.
Ajamil ने अपने जीवन में क्या किया, संघर्ष किया।
Staying in the Vishnu temple.
विष्णु मंदिर में रहकर।
But Dhritarashtra is he cannot do that.
तो धृतराष्ट्र ने ये नहीं कर पाया।
He cannot go to Vishnu temple. We don't know where was the Vishnu temple. Difficult. So his only hope was to go into the forest, and he did not have much time left.
तो धृतराष्ट्र का धृतराष्ट्र ना वो विष्णु मंदिर गए और उनका समय का भी अभाव था और वो ये भी नहीं जानते थे और गए भी नहीं है, तो समय कम होने के कारण वो जंगल गए।
It was the end of his life. He was, you know, practically dead.
तो इसलिए उनका अंतिम समय में उनका जो मृत्यु है वो प्रैक्टिकल में।
So the best thing he could get was liberation.
तो उनके लिए सबसे अच्छा था कि वे मुक्ति प्राप्त करें।
Not everybody can be the devotee. You need to get the mercy.
तो सभी लोग आसान से भक्त नहीं बन सकते, उनके लिए आशीर्वाद जो ब्लेसिंग है वो जरूरी है।
कृष्णा चूजेस हिज डिवोटीज।
तो भगवान भी उसमें निरीक्षण करेंगे
So Krishna didn't choose Dhritarashtra.
So Krishna was Dhritarashtra ke jaise wo
because he'd been so offensive to his devotees.
Kyunki Dhritarashtra ne bahut hi gahan aparadh kiya.
Gopal Chapao, he was offensive also to devotee, but he got relief from his sin.
So Chapal Gopal ne bhi bhakta ke upar unhone aparadh kiye the, lekin phir bhi wo liberate ho gaye.
But for some time he suffered. He had leprosy. He was suffering.
लेकिन कुछ समय तक उन्होंने बहुत दर्दनाक दुख प्राप्त किया, उनको कोर की बीमारी भी हो गया।
So he got reactions, but then he became repentant and he begged mercy.
पहले उन्होंने दुख का सामना किया क्योंकि वो अपराध के कारण, लेकिन उसके बाद में उनको साथ-साथ कृपा भी प्राप्त हुई।
So then Mahaprabhu told him, you have to go to the devotee you've offended, you have to get freed from your offenses.
तो महाप्रभु ने बोला कि जिनके ऊपर आपने, जिस भक्तों के ऊपर आपने चरण में अपराध किए थे, उनके पास जाइए और उनसे क्षमा याचना करो।
Dhritarashtra couldn't do that.
तो Dhritarashtra ने ये सब नहीं किए। Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna. Any other question? Okay. Hare Krishna. Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Gaur Premanande.
Hare Krishna. Thank you very much, Maharaj, for coming and give us association. Thank you very much. So we all request to Maharaj, please keep and come and give us association, guide us, teach us in the path of devotion. Thank you very much. So, सबको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद है। तो आज शाम को भी हमारा यहाँ पर कीर्तन होगा, प्रोग्राम होगा, तो महाराज आज शाम को भी क्लास दे रहे हैं, तो आप सभी लोग आएंगे, तो क्योंकि शास्त्र में श्रीमद् भागवतम एक स्कंदर में बताए है ना, कल भी हम सुन रहे थे, शुशुशुर सदा दानश्च वासुदेवा कथा रुचि श्याम महत् सेवाय विप्रा पुण्य कीर्तन श्रवण। तो हमें श्रवण और कीर्तन में कब रुचि जागृत होगा, कब होगा, जब हम वैष्णव का सेवा करेंगे, वो भी जो इस भौतिक संसार से डिटैच है, और जो अभी महाराज अपने मूवमेंट के लिए, रूपा जी के प्रसन्नता के लिए, भगवान कृष्ण के प्रसन्नता के लिए वो प्रचार करते हुए भ्रमण कर रहे हैं, तो कितने समय के बाद, महीने, दो महीने, तीन महीने के बाद हमें कुछ मुश्किल से हमें एसोसिएशन मिलता है, तो इस एसोसिएशन का लाभ उठाना चाहिए। तो सेवा का मतलब सुनना, नहीं तो श्रवण कीर्तन, हम श्रवण कीर्तन में तभी रुचि आएगा जब हम साधु की सेवा, तो साधु की सेवा कैसे करेंगे, सुनकर, है ना, भगवान कृष्ण कितने बार भगवद गीता भागवतम बोल रहे है ना, सुनना है तत्सुनो, तो सुनना है, तो ये सुनकर कृपा प्राप्त करना चाहिए। तो हम देख सकते हैं कि इवन नारद मुनि जब भक्ति वेदांत का सेवा कर रहे थे है ना, तो उस समय भक्ति वेदांत को नारद मुनि ने कभी ये नहीं बोला कि ब्लेस मी, मुझे कृपा कीजिए, नहीं, वो मुझे कृपा कीजिए ये बोलने से उन्होंने क्या किया ये नहीं बोला, लेकिन उन्होंने कॉन्स्टेंट सुना, श्रवण किया, तो इसी से नारद मुनि ने परम सिद्धि को प्राप्त किए। तो इसलिए हम सभी को आना चाहिए। तो महाराज को स्वागत करते हुए तीन बार हरे कृष्ण मंत्र बोलिए,
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। पतितानां पावनेभ्यो
वैष्णवेभ्यो अनंत कोटि वैष्णवेभ्यो स्वामी महाराज के जय।